21st chapter, 23rd verse.
Yep, Revelation. Just give God some more hand praise, amen, hallelujah, glory to God. Amen, so it says in Revelations 21 and 22, start at 22. And I saw no temple there, for the Lord God Almighty and the Lamb are the temple of it. Now check this out, y'all, check this out. And I saw no temple there, for the Lord God Almighty and the Lamb are the temple of it. And the city had no need of the sun, neither of the moon to shine in it, for the glory of God did lighten it. So what lit the city?
The glory of God.
The glory of God lit the city, right?
Yep.
Okay. And the Lamb is what? The light thereof. So who is the light of the city?
The Lamb.
The Lamb.
Amen.
The Lamb is the light of the city.
Amen.
So he gets, when Christ is glorified, he is the rays that keep the heaven lit.
Amen.
Woo! And see, the Father is glorified in the Son. So every time we ask Christ for something, every time we knock on the door for something, the Father gets glorified in the Son. Christ becomes glorified by the Father. Every time we ask. I asked this question to myself when I was reading John. Why is Christ constantly asking the disciples to ask him for something? He says, ask me and I'll give it to you. Ask me anything in my name and I'm going to do for you. I'm like, why is he constantly asking that of them all the time? Read that, you will find out. Asking and shall be given, seeking you shall find. Ask me and I'll do it for you. Ask me and my Father will do it for you. Ask me, it's like, will you please just hurry up and do something right now? Open up your mouth, wave your hands, stomp your feet, do something, because heaven is in jeopardy unless you ask me to do something for you. Oh man, hallelujah, glory to God. Did y'all hear what I just said?
Yes.
Heaven is in jeopardy unless we ask Christ to help us.
Right.
Because if we don't ask him, he's not glorified. If he's not glorified, heaven goes dark.
Right.
That's why God said it's my good pleasure to give you the kingdom.
Amen.
I want to encourage you to come to my Son and ask whatever you want, because I want to give it to you. Because as you ask him, I can glorify my Son, which keeps heaven lit.
Thank you, Lord.
And my kingdom is a kingdom of light, not of darkness. That's why it's more blessed to give than it is to receive.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus said it's more blessed for me to give to you than to receive from you. Because if I give to you, the Father is glorified in me and my rays light heaven. That's why I want to give. That's why I wanted to give my life. Oh, man, that's that. Amen. Hallelujah. I want to give my love. I want to give my possessions. I want to give my blessings. I want to give these spiritual things, the precious jewels, the riches, the wisdom, the honor, the glory, and the blessing. I receive it so I can give it. I didn't receive it to keep it. Because if I keep it, the lights go out. I become just like that other person that we cast out. Hallelujah, glory to God. Because he comes to kill, steal, and to destroy. His kingdom is dark because he's stingy. Y'all gotta catch that. His kingdom is dark because he don't like giving. He likes holding back stuff. He'll give you his stuff, but he won't give you the right stuff. Amen, praise God. Hallelujah, glory to God. He'll give you stuff that'll cause you to go crazy, lose your mind. Amen. Praise God. He'll give you riches with sorrow. Oh, y'all got a head start. Amen. He'll let you accumulate wealth and go crazy.
Amen.
Be so paranoid that you can't come out your house no more. No, hallelujah. You can't even walk down the steps or walk in your own house and be like, oh, I'm going to get a disease. Oh, you can't come. I can't even use, I can only use this cell phone one time and then I got to throw it away.
Yeah.
Living a crazy life like that. What good is your money if you don't share it with somebody?
Yeah.
What good is all the wealth if you don't buy something for somebody and let somebody else enjoy the accumulation of what you got?
Amen.
That's a lonely life, y'all. Amen. Praise God.
Amen.
You get money to spend it. That's what it's for.
Amen.
It's to give it.
Amen.
To release it, to help somebody else out with it, not to hoard it like some old crony in a cave, like a hermit. Amen. Won't invest in nothing and nobody. Amen. Praise God. That's not what money is for. That's not what riches is for. That's not even what salvation is for you to get it all, then go into your seclusion, go on a sabbatical for the rest of your life and don't tell nobody. Want to be some kind of wizard and genie? Like, oh, I'm deep. You ain't that deep, amen. You ain't telling nobody about the goodness of God. You ain't even a witness, amen. You ain't even a Jehovah witness, amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Yes.
That's a whole nother story.
Amen.
Amen. Because how can you be a Jehovah Witness and not want the Spirit of God in your life to do it?
Amen. Amen.
Amen. There's more than one kingdom. Oh, I got one time. I got to stay on point, y'all. I got one time. Amen. Praise God. He said, do you believe the kingdom of God is here? I'm like, yeah, I believe it's here too. And I'm working and I'm operating in the kingdom right here too. And, yep, and I know that there's going to be a new heaven and a new earth. Amen. Now what? But what are you talking about? Then I broke him down. I said, what about the Spirit of God? Why are you denying Jesus Christ? And do you collect an offering at your church? Oh, we don't do that. I said, you're lying. Because how does your church operate without money? Excel energy don't work on faith. Amen. That works by money. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Praise God. Your light don't stay on you. Heat don't stay on because of faith. It stays on because of money. Somebody's paying money. There's a transfer of money somewhere. Amen. Praise God. And the money is coming in from y'all. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. It just don't materialize. I don't care if you take an offering plate and go around in the back. Amen. If somebody drop it off in a big old bowl, you're still getting money.
Yeah.
Period. You can't even live in your apartment unless you pay the rent. Try that, Jehovah's Witness. Try to witness to your landlord like that. Oh, in the name of Jesus. God said, I don't have to pay my rent. But you don't pay it in 30 days, we're going to give you a notice. And then we're going to show you how much faith we got in what you said. None. Bye. Get out. Amen. Praise God.
Sure.
Oh, it's hard, but it's just the truth, though.
Sure. Come for the
mouth. Amen. Praise God. You're evicted because you didn't pay your rent. We don't hear all of that. We hear like money. Money talks here. Practical things, real things. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. And that's what God is about, real stuff. Amen.
Amen.
And He wants to give us that in order for us to be more influential. You see what I'm saying? Money don't make us, we make the money. Y'all got to catch that. Amen. Praise God. Money don't make us, money don't change us. It shouldn't anyway.
Amen.
It shouldn't change your character.
Amen.
It shouldn't change your attitude towards people. Amen, praise God. That's just a medium of exchange, a piece of paper with some color on it, validated by the government as tender to buy goods and services.
Amen.
That's all it is. It's a dead tree. That's all it is. It's a dead tree with some ink on it. That's it. Hallelujah, glory. That's all it is. That's all it is. That's all it is. It came from the same place we came from.
Right.
Dirt. Ooh.
Real talk.
Dirt. We all came from dirt. And we're going right back to the dirt. Am I right about it?
Yes,
amen. I say that when I do a committal. As is, does the dust. The good Lord gave it, and the good Lord taketh away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And the spirit goes back to the person that gave it. The body goes back to the ground. The spirit goes back to the person that gave it. And who gave us our spirit? God breathed in us the breath of life and we became a living soul. Amen. Praise God. And so knowing that we're going to either meet God through death or the resurrection, it behooves us not to get ourselves prepared for this event.
Amen.
We need to get prepared for that event. Whether we die or get raptured up, we need to be prepared. Amen. Praise God. To arm ourselves likewise.
Yeah.
That he that suffered in the flesh has ceased from sin. Amen. Praise God. And to know that sin is leaving your body's gonna start suffering. That's an indication that sin is leaving your body. Because your body's starting to suffer. Ooh. Did you know that? Did you know that's when sin is leaving your body? Because sin wants to stay in it. And when you starve it, your body suffers.
Amen.
When you starve sin and feed your faith, you suffer your body. Ooh, catch that. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. You see that? Amen. You see when that demonic boy, amen, when he was deaf and dumb, remember that? And the father asked the disciples, can you help me? The disciples couldn't help. This one was for Jesus. Say, this one is for Jesus. Amen.
For Jesus.
Hallelujah. This one is for Jesus. Jesus came along and said, what's going on? He said, this my boy, the devil is taking him and throwing him into the fire and into the water. Okay? You got two extremes. Two extremes that are taking place here. Fire and water. At a young age. Now the boy was deaf and he was dumb. He couldn't hear and he couldn't speak. So he couldn't vocalize what was going on with him at a young age. How bad and what kind of bondage could that be? For you to be in such torment by an enemy, by a spirit, and you can't vocalize or tell anybody what's going on with you. And he couldn't hear. So if somebody wanted to help him, he couldn't hear them. And so the father, seeing his son, he was helpless. His son was pining away, meaning pining means to slowly deteriorate. How is that for a parent to see their child, their daughter, or their son slowly deteriorate and they're helpless? Do you know what kind of pain and agony that is? To see your son and daughter under the influence of a spirit that you have no authority over and you can't do nothing about it, and it has episodes, epileptic episodes, lunatic type episodes, gyrations, foaming at the mouth, being physically distorted in their appearance because the spirit drove them into the fire. So you can imagine what this child looked like coming out the fire multiple times and then being pushed into the water to try to drown it, to try to kill it. And he's just a young child. Can you imagine how he felt amongst his peers and his friends? How they must have looked at him. How they must have acknowledged him or talked about him or even probably made fun of him, because I'm sure there were some mean kids back there then too.
Amen.
How they didn't want to have no association with him because of his deformity and the thing that he was going with. Some might have even been afraid of him. This is a little kid now. This wasn't a grown-up person by themselves. This was a little boy. Now look at the parent who is helpless and can't do nothing about it. How would you feel? Your son and your daughter is dying. Your best friend is dying. Your cousin, your relative is dying. And you can't do nothing about it. You're helpless. And then you go to the church people. Oh, now surely they would have a cure. Surely church would be the answer. Surely somebody in there could be able to help me, give me a word or something, loan me some money or something. Then you get to the church people and they couldn't, with all of their vocabulary, with all of their decrees and all of their declarations and all of this power and all of this hype service, they can't cast the devil out of a little boy. And the sad thing about it was that them disciples, Christ gave them power about two or three chapters earlier, before they met this episode, Christ gave them power to cast out demons.
Wow.
And now when it was put to the test, they couldn't do it. Now how discouraging is that? That you go to the house of God where you are supposed to get your deliverance and your situation doesn't change. How would you feel when those that are speaking in tongues lay hands on your kid and your kid leaves the same and they couldn't do nothing? How does that affect your faith now? Decree and declare it. Oops, there it is. In the middle, you got the people that can't cast out the devil out of your kids. Right in the middle. You're getting weary and well doing. You don't want to depend on them no more because it's not happening. You've exhausted your resources. Natural science can't help you. The church can't help you. Who do you go to? Somebody say, Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ.
Jesus, Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. When he hit the scene, when Jesus stepped on the platform, y'all got When his presence hit the atmosphere,
yeah,
everything changed. Oh, oh, hallelujah, glory to God. Woo! See, the one thing that that little boy had going for him, that we have going for us, is purpose and destiny.
Amen. Amen.
He had purpose and destiny going on for him. Man, praise God. I thought I was going to stay with the lesson. It's something different again. Amen. Hallelujah. Yeah. Glory to God. We're going to let it flow. Amen.
Amen.
Purpose and destiny.
Amen.
Those two kept that child alive. Can you imagine going under after being burned? Excruciating. Fire hurts, y'all. Y'all know that.
Yeah.
In the fire. Purpose and destiny pulling them out the fire. It's not your time yet, son. You can't die.
Yeah.
Devil drives him into the water. They throw in a rescue. Rescue who? Pull him out. Purpose and destiny. Come on, purpose. Come on, destiny. Pull me, purpose. Pull me, destiny. Pull me. You get his hand, purpose, and destiny, I'll grab your arm. And we're going to pull this boy out because God has something more for him to do. He has to be included in one of the gospels. That's how important his life is. He can't die. Purpose, don't let go. Destiny, don't let go of me. Purpose, don't let go of him. And they're just pulling. Destiny is pulling purpose. Purpose is pulling the kid. Oh, y'all got to hear because he got a calling on his life. Why do you think y'all made it out of what you've been in?
Amen.
Why do you think y'all survived those traumatic events in your life?
Amen.
It was purpose and destiny pulling on you. Yes, it is. It was purpose and destiny. It was pulling on you. How do you think we lived so long? Purpose and destiny was pulling on you. While we were deformed, while we were messed up, while we couldn't vocalize what was going on with us. Y'all catch that? Amen. Praise God. Why we couldn't hear, why we couldn't even hear the voice of God? Because we had deaf ears, clouded by sin. Deaf ears shut down by transgressions. Deaf ears shut down by promiscuity and idle chatter. Amen. Praise God. Having our vision distorted.
Yeah.
Having our image distorted because of the wiles of the enemy. Had hit us so hard. We thought we was right, but we was wrong. We thought we was clean, amen, and upright. But but on the inside, we was defiled, messed up. Spirit was filthy. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Image was marred. Identity was lost. So we picked up a tag name. Because we forgot who we were. And we let man name us and define us instead of letting God do it. Ooh.
Yeah.
And so we get lost in the crowd, lost in the game, lost in our relationships, lost in our marriages, lost in the church, lost in the house.
Mm-hmm. All right, man.
Lost in the house. Image has been marred. Coming to church out of tradition. Coming to church out of routine. Lost in the house.
Mm-hmm.
Not knowing the purpose. Not knowing our purpose and our destiny when we come. Not tapping into the power of God when we come. Why? Because Satan has given us locked jaws. We don't praise him like we should. Locked our jaws.
Right.
Locked our jaws.
Right.
We don't open up and praise God with a purpose. We don't give him honor with a purpose. We just come out of routine because maybe the preacher says, okay, everybody give God some praise. See, it's the difference when you do it with intention. When you do it for a reason, then out of routine. Because you can become Ichabod right in the church.
Amen.
You can have the apparatus, but the glory of God would have left your temple.
Amen.
Ichabod in the church, looking good. You got the connected to the bloodline. Part of the house, part of the lineage. Know the rudiments. Know how to win the walk, win the talk, when to lift up your hands, when to pray. Know when offering is coming. Know when altar call is coming. Know when to go to bathroom. Know when to put the finger. But I still don't know what that means, but people do it. I don't know what that means. Amen. Praise God. That means I'm leaving. Why you got to put your finger up? Just say bye. Bye. Just say excuse me. Amen. Praise God. What? I guess that's something somebody else started and everybody else does it and nobody knows why they do it. Amen. Praise God. So we got all these gyrations down, but there's no spirit on the inside. Our temple has been deserted. It's a ghost town. And now we're trying to operate out of an empty vessel. Trying to operate ministry without the minister.
Amen.
Trying to speak in tongues. Hallelujah. And the initiator is gone. And so you have a lot of people, and I can tell when people are speaking in false tongues, but because of my awareness and fear of speaking against God,
Amen.
I don't say nothing about it, because that's for God to judge.
Amen.
But I can tell when you make up a tongue just like that, that's just echoes of what used to be.
Wow.
I said, that's just echoes of what used to be there. Like when you hit a tin can that's empty, bing, and you hear the noise of it. That's something used to be there. It's empty now. That's why it's echoing. And so when somebody is making themselves speak in tongues, that's an echo of what used to be. They remember the terminology and they try to mimic what they heard before. Oh, y'all gotta catch that. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Oh, they're trying to copycat what they heard in somebody else's service.
Amen.
And because they want to be connected and get this spiritual language, amen, praise God. They want it so bad that they'll give in to whatever Satan presents to them. And they'll be lost in the house and don't know it. Ichabod in the church, not able to function fully under the anointing and the auspices of God. Amen, praise God. Give God some hand, praise. Amen. Hallelujah.